by the inverse Laplace transform of 1 over s squared plus 1 times s squared plus 4. First, looking at this, we cannot find the Laplace inverse Laplace transform of this one because it doesn't match any one of the formulas we learned. So we need to make it look like the one we know. So for this one, I'm going to use the fractional fraction decomposition method to find its fractions. But I'm not going to go over the process. And what I'm going to do is to use a shortcut. So we need to have something over s squared plus 1 plus something over s squared plus 4. So this can be obtained from the summation of these. By the way, if you haven't had a chance to watch the video about finding partial fractions in less than 30 seconds, I'll put the link in the upper right corner here. You can go there and check it out. As you notice, they are off by 3. So I'm going to have 1/3 on the numerator. And the next step is to determine which one has a negative sign. So as I experienced, the bigger one will carry the negative sign. So this one, plus 1, plus 4, so plus 1, this is a bigger one, so it has the negative sign. Then you check it. So you have negative 1/3 s squared plus 1/3 s squared equals 0, negative 1/3 times 1, plus 4 over 3, which is 3 over 3, which is 1. Okay, so we're good. Now, I'm going to write this out into two fractions and apply the inverse to it. Factor out 1/3. I have L inverse of 1 over s squared plus 1 minus 1/3. L inverse of 1 over s squared plus 4. So for this one, this is L inverse of 1 over s squared plus 1 is equal to psi t. For this one, L inverse of 1 over s squared plus 4, so it's almost close to the psi form, but we need to have the k on top, and in this k, the k is 2. So the formula says that for psi, we have to have k over s squared plus k squared, and our k is 2, so we need to have the 2 on top. But it doesn't have the 2 on top even initially, because this is what I just put in. Then I have to divide by 1/2 to compensate. Okay, so I have negative 1 over 6 times L inverse of 2 over s squared plus 4 is equal to psi of 2t. So this is your final answer. If you're not sure, you can take the Laplace transform of this and this. So then it should be divided to this one. So that's how you take the answer. That's it.
If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.